guys? And Bassoonist here with a brand new video for the channel. And today we're gonna be talking about what a bassoon is. Now, I made a video on what a bassoonist's life is like. Well, we're gonna be talking about what a bassoon is. I think a lot of people don't really know what a bassoon is, and that's fine. So watch this video because you're gonna get informed today. If you guys know someone who doesn't really know anything about a bassoon, feel free to share this video with them, and hopefully I can entertain them. Alright, so right next to me is the bassoon, and this is what an average bassoon looks like. This is a German bassoon. There are French bassoons and Baroque bassoons, but the Baroque and French bassoon are not very common in the classical musician industry. And the bassoon is a woodwind instrument. That means that a musician is required to blow into the instrument. The bassoon just requires you to blow. The bassoon is also made out of wood, which some woodwind instruments are made out of metal. So, you know, we always got wood. Anyways, the bassoon is also a double reed instrument, which means that I play on a reed that has two canes put together, two pieces of cane put together. But this instrument is quite fun to play. It's very unique. As you can see, it is quite a big instrument, as it is almost the height of my hair, but it's pretty much taller than me as sitting down. It's not that heavy, it's about 15 pounds. I mean, it's a really interesting instrument and is very unique. Just based off the looks, I think you'll be very impressed on how it actually sounds when it is played. Like I had mentioned earlier, it's required to have a reed in order to produce sound. As you can see, this little section here is called the vocal, and I had made a video earlier on what vocals are, and you guys can go ahead and check that out on my YouTube channel. I probably will have a pop-up link either here, so feel free to check out that video. It's pretty informational on what vocals are, but the bassoon requires a vocal in order to attach the reed. And if I were to just blow into this vocal here, there is no sound. I will set this instrument down. What is needed for this instrument to project sound is a reed. And as you can see from all the way over here, it is very, very tiny. However, I'm gonna move up and show you a lot closer of an angle. It is this interesting looking thing, which is called cane. And it's a double reed. As you can see, there's two slabs kind of put together. And in this way, you'll be able to buzz on it like this. But you also want, for bassoons, you want a sound that sounds like this. From that, you have the sound that comes out from this reed, and from there, we will attach it onto the vocal, which is, like I mentioned, the attachment from the reed to the instrument, and from here, we have sound. Alright, hopefully I'm in this shot. If I'm not, well, that's unfortunate. But with the bassoon, I think a lot of people are kind of confused on how it works and the mechanics of it. But mainly with instruments, airflow is definitely a big thing, because that is something that has to flow through the instrument. Now, the bassoon is very unique looking. As you can see, if you look at this picture, this is my drawing of a bassoon. But this is what a bassoon looks like. Now, the airflow works that in a way where you have the air that starts up here, goes up into the instrument, comes down again, and at the bottom joint of the instrument, there's actually kind of two parts, except at the bottom they're joined. So in this way that the air flows up into the vocal, down into the instrument, then at the bottom it comes back up through the bell at the top. And that's kind of how the instrument works, with airflow and all that kind of stuff. I apologize if the drawings aren't that good, but anyways. So now we're gonna get to the playing part of the bassoon. Now, this is a body strap like the saxophone. This instrument is kind of shaped in a way where the musician or player needs to wear some sort of strap in order to hold the bassoon securely. and play it with lots of technique and style. So that is the reason why I'm wearing this backpack looking thing, body strap, however you want to call it. Let's get straight into playing the instrument. Tell this instrument has a very wide range of musical notes that it can play, from a high range to a low range. And like I had mentioned, it is a very, very unique instrument that not a lot of instruments have this kind of characteristics and sound to it. So that's what the bassoon is, and yeah. Alright guys, I'm going to end the video here. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and if you did, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to my channel down below by hitting that subscribe button if you haven't done so. And once again, I hope you guys learned a lot. If you guys know that there are friends who don't know about the bassoon, don't forget to share this video with them. And if you guys have any videos that you guys want to see on my channel, don't hesitate to leave a comment down below in the comment section. I would love to read them. If you guys have any things that you want to add to what a bassoon is, don't forget, feel free to leave it in the comment section below. And I hope you guys enjoyed the video once again, and I will see you guys later.